Let me demonstrate a rudimentary developmental process with this epoch robot. On the right, I will explain how we represent the sequence of interactions enacted by the robot over time. We call this temporal representation an activity trace. The robot has infrared diodes and sensors that it can use to detect the presence of walls in front, to the left, or to the right. The robot turns on the corresponding diode and activates the corresponding sensor. The sensor returns a bit that indicates whether the reflected light exceeds a threshold, which signals a wall within approximately 5 cm. For each sensor, however, the robot ignores what this bit means, 0 for wall and 1 for no wall, or the opposite. The robot can also use its motors to turn approximately 90 degrees to the left or to the right, or to move forward approximately 5 cm. However, it initially ignores the effect of these actions, as if it activated muscles while ignoring what these muscles are doing. While moving forward, the robot can detect whether it bumps into a wall, in which case the movement is interrupted. A binary feedback is returned, but the robot initially ignores its meaning, 0 for bump or 1 for no bump, or the opposite. When choosing an action, the robot not only ignores which infrared light or motor it activates, but even whether it corresponds to an infrared light or a motor. Moreover, it ignores the meaning of the feedback bit that it receives from this action. It's important to understand that the robot has no other way of knowing its environment than through the single bit that it receives as a result of its actions. It even ignores that it exists in space, that it can move, and that walls exist in its environment. Therefore, at the beginning, the robot must babble like a newborn baby to learn to make sense of all possibilities of interaction afforded by its coupling with the environment. We call this learning phase the learning of sensory motor contingencies. Additionally, the robot has an inborn preference for moving forward, a strong inborn dislike for bumping into walls, and a slight dislike for turning and for using sensors. This histogram indicates the inborn valence of interactions, in red when negative and in green when positive. I'm going to show a video that demonstrates that the robot learns to use its sensors in spite of its slight dislike for using them, as if it understood that the sensors inform it of the presence or absence of walls, so it can safely move forward and avoid bumping into walls. Here we start. Front empty again, left empty, right empty, front empty, move forward, front empty, move forward, left empty, front wall, left empty, right wall, false detection in fact, move forward bump, left empty, turn left, front empty, right wall, left empty, turn right, front wall, front empty, bump, front wall, left, front empty, forward, front empty, forward, left, front empty, forward, right, left, right, empty, front empty, forward, right empty, front empty, forward, front empty, forward, front wall, left, front empty. So here we see that it started to use the front sensor and move forward when it finds it empty, and not move forward when it finds there is a wall. Front wall, left, front empty, move forward. Front empty, move forward, front empty, move forward, front empty, move forward, front empty, move forward, front wall, turn left, front empty, move forward. This gray and black line on top of the trace indicates the level of learning. When the line is at the bottom level, it means that the robot chooses one interaction at a time. When it is at the second level, it indicates that the robot chooses a sequence of two interactions in a row, namely sense empty, then move forward. This utilization of previously learned sequences is a form of self-programming. When the robot unexpectedly senses a wall, the sequence is interrupted, and then the robot makes another decision. The black segment in the line indicates the interruption of a second order sequence. Note that this learning does not only consist of moving forward when a wall is sensed, but more importantly, of actively using the appropriate sensor to assess the current situation. This active perception emerges out of the robot's activity. It radically differs from traditional machine learning algorithms in which the agent's perception is predefined. Another difference with traditional AI is that the robot has no final concrete goal, such as reaching a particular position or state. Therefore, we do not assess its learning through its performance in reaching a goal, but through behavioral analysis based on activity traces to demonstrate the emergence of cognitive behaviors.